publication from the CDC that came out in August of this year. That, you know, the CDC did an investigation that really looked into an outbreak. This particular paper looked at an outbreak into COVID at a facility in Maryland, and what they found was, you know, in a 200-bed facility that specialized in post-acute and long-term care, they had 32 dialysis residents that were being transported out to outpatient dialysis facilities, and 15 of the 32 patients, or 47%, had tested COVID positive, whereas only 22 of the rest of the patients, 22 of 138 of the non-dialysis patients were positive. So the takeaway here is that a significant higher proportion of the dialysis patients tested positive for COVID in those that were being transported out. And a caveat from this paper is that of the COVID positive patients, looking at 30-day hospitalization, the COVID positive dialysis patients had a much higher rate of hospitalization during 30 days when compared to COVID positive patients that were not requiring dialysis. And I guess the hypothesis really is what we've been talking about here today, that the potential exposures are significant with patients from the facility in the transport van, the patients in the community that are coming to the outpatient dialysis facility, and the staff and the transport back. So I think providing on-site dialysis really limits the number of potential exposures that these dialysis patients will come into contact with.